There's an interesting case there in the newspapers or in the media reported today. It's a court ruling in Waterford involving a 68-year-old man who has had difficulties with his mortgage. He fell into reduced mortgage payments or fell into arrears, but the Circuit Court overruled an objection by the Ulster Bank by allowing this handyman in Waterford to remain in his home and pay a mortgage of just €93 a month for life in a personal insolvency arrangement. Given that the man is 68 years of age, he's now being permitted to pay €93 a month until he's 98. This case, it's said, could help thousands of others because the Central Bank has rode in as well, and they have actually given their seal of approval to it insofar as it's an innovative and imaginative solution, perhaps. Remember, this man is 68, so getting a mortgage after, you know, 60, 65, 70 is difficult at the best of times, and yet he's going to pay a reduced payment of €93 a month in this personal insolvency arrangement, which will last until he's 98 if he lives that long. And if he doesn't live that long, obviously the life insurance will take care of whatever is outstanding. The case is seen as providing a potential solution for many in long-term mortgage arrears who are over the age of 60 and don't have sufficient income to repay mortgages in full. The man in question had only 5 years left on his mortgage when he sought financial help, but he couldn't afford the €1,621 mortgage repayment. The court was told he would not be able to rent at market rates either, and he didn't meet the eligibility requirements for a mortgage to the rent scheme, so his chance of securing social housing would be remote. He retired in February 2020 and is relying on the state a pension for income. A very important point and salient point is that the house is valued at €210,000, whereas there's only €97,000 remaining on the mortgage, so he has quite a bit of equity in this property. The judge, Mary Enright, approved the personal insolvency scheme or the debt arrangement scheme, where he'll be allowed to remain in the house for his lifetime on the reduced mortgage repayments until he's 98 years of age. The arrangement arranged in court by Keith Farry proposed that the bank recoup the mortgage debt in full from the sale of the property if he dies before then. So this is obviously something that is a case which might provide a solution for many other people in similar situations, because the arrangement, we're told in the article there that there could be 8,000 people in the mortgage arrears in the southeast and more than 28,000 nationally. And the alternative to the plan that the judge has approved would be that the gentleman in question would be essentially become homeless, whereas this solution has come at zero cost to the state, as there's no requirement for social housing. And as somebody said there, the problem with being over the age of 60 is that you just don't have enough working life left to pay the mortgage in full on a capital and interest basis. Previously, such a mechanism could only have been agreed where it had the support of the mortgage lender, but the court ruling meant the objection of this lender could be overruled. And the Central Bank, as I say, has given it the seal of approval and has approved this and has seen it as an innovative way to deal with arrears for persons who are 60 or 65 years of age and don't have a lot of income coming in and have debts, but perhaps have equity as well, and perhaps have property which ultimately will realise more than enough to pay off the bank. Hope you find this video useful. If you do, I'd appreciate it if you gave it the thumbs up down below. Thanks a lot.